What is up, guys? Today's video, we are back with one of the best players of all time instead of Clash Royale, Moogie. Moogie actually got 8,000 trophies, which is already an insanely great achievement with this G-Pok psychic, but he's also level 12 and he beat one of the hardest matchups, like the toughest match in general with this Hawk psychic. He's absolutely insane. He's one of the best players instead of Clash Royale ever, considering for me, if it's about just the gameplay itself, the best player ever, in my opinion. He's so skilled, especially with psychic decks. He's like able to get like a full potential of them, and he's just insane. If you guys don't want to miss any videos in the future on the channel, don't forget to subscribe. Also, using creator good mod is highly appreciated. I would say let's jump to the games, which Moogie brought 8,000 trophies. Here we go, guys. Here in the first game, and we are going to go over really tough matchups. So I actually have like a Lava Hound deck. He's playing his Hawkeye Q Firecracker Psychic deck, kind of similar to the deck which I showed, but he actually uses this deck because he doesn't have any other decks maxed out. So this is the deck he needs to use. And people always tell me, or like will tell me also in the comment section, level 12, that's not a big disadvantage, but it is. If you play against the best players in the world, the 300 damage at your tower really, really makes a difference. And also, which makes a difference is the damage against Lava on decks. An example, your tower needs 3 shots for the Lava pups. And also sometimes in some interactions, the Hawk Rider gets more, like one more shot, Beyblade gets more shots, Pega gets more shots. So this is just like insanely, like underrated, I feel like, this level change. So this is going to be the Pekka Bridge Spam matchup. And first of all, yeah, we're starting with a damage, or like with a HP disadvantage against him. He's just gonna go in for like kind of cycling stuff. He has the Snowball, Electro Wizard, Pekka, Ramber. So how the heck is Moogie gonna break through? Especially your opponent has Lightning. So we're able to build a huge push like with a Ramber in the back. And we're just lighting a Tesla. So he needs to go for a Firecracker, which nobody really wants. And I think he's just gonna drop a Valkyrie here. Just to make sure the Beyblade gets distracted. And also gets some value at offense. Because he still has to respond to it at the same time he went with an Electro Wizard in the back. So I think the opponent's just going to cycle Snowball most likely. Moogie's just going to drop an Ice Spirit here. By the way, Moogie's channel will be in the description below, so make sure to check out Moogie's YouTube channel. He's just putting out insanely great content with cheap decks, with different decks, with beatdown decks. So just like different ladder pushes. Kind of similar content as I do, so make sure. If you enjoy me, you will enjoy him as well, because he's one of the best players of all time. So just going for a Tesla high. We're just going to go in for the great, insanely good King to activation. And most of you guys, like even me in this situation, would have just played a Valkyrie. Because like, okay, Valkyrie, just easy cleanup, right? And still counter push. No, one Elixir, Ice Bird, King to activation. You guys see Moogie would do that over and over again. Just going for cheap King to activation. So he just got Snowball this. But right now, Moogie just want to keep up pressure. He's just going for Valkyrie. Hawkwire doesn't get a hit. He will just most likely Ice Bird this and maybe Skeletons also. He could do that at least. He's just gonna lock it. Missed lock! Moogie did a mistake. I cannot believe he actually missed a lock. But a huge, not a huge deal. So he's just gonna go for another Firecracker. Just going for Valkyrie high. Is he going to Hawk Rider behind this? Yes, he's going to Hawk Rider behind it. And the opponent is not able to go in for his Pekka because he doesn't have enough Elixir. Electrozer plus Ram Rider is going to clean it up. And the Ram Rider is going to go in for the Tesla. So I think next play is going to be the Skeletons. Oh, he kind of messed it up also. So Moogie's doing mistakes, but how is he going to come back? One more Electro Wizard shot just because of the tower disadvantage here. I think he's just going to go, yeah, Hawk Rider opposite. He wants to make sure that he's going opposite lane. Your opponent does just respond with Electro Wizard. Plus Snowball, perfect Snowball. Snowball even better against Hawk Rider after the recent buff. So he's just going to opponent and scratch and go for a Lightning Cycle. So the question for me right now is, how the heck is Moogie coming back from this huge disadvantage? Perfect Barbarian Bell from the opponent. Like, not really perfect, but perfect. So he's just going to drop a Valkyrie. He doesn't really care about the about the connection on this side. I think now he's just going for another Hawk Rider behind the Valkyrie. Or no, he's not. But how is Moogie coming back? This is the big question. Everybody's asking, like, how the heck is Moogie coming back from this disadvantage? He's not going to get any hits. The Electros are going to be enough, especially with the Snowball here. And he's just going for this. So he's just going for Skeletons here. Just going for Valkyrie here. And he's just going to go Hawk opposite. Especially with the Ice Bird here. Maybe slows down the Ram Rider. He's going to get like 2 Hawk Rider shots. Or like 1 Hawk Rider shot. Like never 2. He really will never get 2 in this matchup. So he needs to be careful with Lightning. So he's just gonna go for Valkyrie High in case your opponent has enough elixir for lightning. So he's going for the band is gonna get a charge here. And I think this has to be over right now. But you guys see, Mugi's going for a lock. He's going most likely for an and he's not going for any Q, but the Hawk Rider is chipping away. Another hit. The Firecracker gets another shot. Now he's most likely gonna go for an Earthquake. Earthquake cycling starting. Going for a lock. Going for Ice Spirit most likely. Just try to protect everything. And now just a pure swell cycle game. Lock EQ will finish off the deal. I don't really know how Mugi's gonna win this. 4 HP. Lock is enough. He needs to clean up with an Ice Spirit. Ice Spirit's coming down. Mugi takes it up. I don't know how, but he is just absolutely not from this planet, guys. Next game, guys. Next game, this Hawk EQ deck really struck against Fireball Bait because you have, yeah, you have the Valkyrie, you have the Tesla, but what do you have against recruits in the back? Flying Machine, big double lane pressure push, especially when I can Fireball your Firecracker. So this is a matchup which I really want to show you because Mugi is playing is absolutely perfect on point. This is how you beat, most likely, like going into German here, this is not the play, but most likely one of the decks which like most people are playing right now, honestly. Like this, Warhawk's Recruit deck is everywhere. So he's just gonna go in for Valkyrie High. Overall, really, really great defense Mugi is doing here. And I think he's just gonna go for Skeletons there. Perfect Skeletons. Now he's gonna support the Hawk Rider. Why he always wants to support the Hawk Rider with a Firecracker? Kinda easy, right? Because of the easy King to activation your opponent is able to do. So he's just gonna go for a lock here. I hope he... is he gonna protect a Firecracker? No, he's not. But maybe it was kinda on purpose because he didn't protect it because the opponent wasn't able to get a King to activation. So maybe there was a smart play by Mugi and just, okay, die, then your opponent is not gonna get a King to activation, especially because I can't really support it because I don't have Valkyrie cycle or something else. So he's just gonna go for an Ice Spirit here, try to chip away, and the opponent is just gonna drop his, Hog is here, so he's not gonna overcommit for a lock. He still takes the counter push for like 5 elixir Valkyrie plus skeletons. Now he's just gonna Hog opposite lane. Hog is coming down now. He's just gonna lock this. Lock is coming down. Hog Rider is also coming down. This is fine. He's gonna get some damage on opponent Osama, which is considered like one of the best recruits player of all time. One of, or like the best recruits player overall in LED. I think he got like a top 10 finish with this deck. So I think he's really happy that this deck is back, but he's not really happy that he's facing like just insanely great Mugi, like who's absolutely ridiculous. Instead of Clash Royale when he's playing on his top level. I'm so excited to compete against him in the world finals. So just going for Firecracker in the back in the same lane. I'm just going for Valkyrie. Just going for Hawk Rider. Now he's just gonna lock this. Okay. He's just gonna go in now for Skeletons to protect this. Awesome protection here by Mugi. But, oh, it worked! What was this? Absolutely insane. Absolutely insane. Now he's just going to Ice Spirit here and another Hawk Rider. The opponent needs to go in for that, but he doesn't have a Cage in Cycle. Now he's going to Cage. EQ is coming down. Mugi just wants to get one shot. He's not going to get it because of perfect Cage basement. Against the Hawk EQ matchup, you want to play the Cage in front of the tower because then the Cage doesn't have to work. If you're going for the middle, your opponent's going to Hawk EQ. You will always get one Hawk Rider shot. If you play it on top of the Hawk, no hits. So just a small tip for you guys. So he's just gonna lock this. Just gonna go in for high Tesla here. This time, the opponent gets the protection in. So he's just going for this. He's just going for Valkyrie plus lock. Most likely Ice Spirit on the left side. No Ice Spirit on the right side is fine. But now his Firecracker won't survive. But at least he will be able to go in for Hawk Rider now at the bridge. Or is he? Or is he just like being patient? Just going for a Firecracker in the back. Yeah, he's just going for a Firecracker because he sees the opponent's going to set up his Zappies and he doesn't really want to push into the Zappies. So he's just going for this, like play his Tesla a bit to the right because of the flying machine being in there. So he's just going to lock this. What a smart lock. Trying. Oh, it actually worked. He locked the recruit spec that the flying machine is tanking. So he's just going to go in for this great defensive. Structure is just going for a lock. Firecracker gets a ton of value. He needs to be a bit careful on both sides because there's some chip damage. He's just going for a Tesla high. Let's see. Is he just going for a Hawk Rider here? Just going for a Hawk Rider. He's just going for another EQ here because he knows the cage needs to come down. Is he going to protect this Firecracker? Yes, he can. Yes, he can. Mugi can do it. He's just going to go in for a lock here. Perfect lock. He's just going for high Valkyrie. Just going for this. This time, unfortunately, the Electric Spirit will connect. Also, no, not going to get any chip damage on the tower. He's just going for a Tesla high to snipe it. I think the right decision. Opponent's going for smart Zappies here, but unfortunately for Osama, he doesn't have Hoggies and Psyker to kind of keep the flying machine alive and get some potential out of that. So he was just going for a lock, yeah, just cycling a lock. He was just most likely going for maybe like another Tesla now. Valkyrie first, another Firecracker, most likely Tesla in the middle now. Tesla's coming down. He's just gonna lock this. He's just gonna Valkyrie this most likely. And this is just, I don't know, that's just brutal defense. But as you can see, Mugi's playing perfect, but still it's not kind of close in the game. But he knows, he has a spell psych advantage. Fireball Lock is doing way more damage than his Osama spell. So he's just going for a Q like this. Just want to make sure he also hits the Zappies to get some more value out of that. Hogwarts scores one important hit, so, but it's still looking really, really spicy. How is he supposed to defend both flying machines? So, actually just going for an Ice Boot here. He's just going for a high Tesla. He's just going to lock this. And he needs to get the Valkyrie down in time. Valkyrie is going to go down 1 second late. Opponent's going to Fireballs. Mugi needs to go for Skeletons. He will just go for an EQ here. He will just go for an Ice Boot. Try to get the Psych as fast as he can. But he's just playing awesome defense. GG's well played. Mugi is, I don't know, like, how should I describe him? He's just not next level. Next level gameplay, guys. Plus 41, by the way. That's huge. And now, guys, we going to the game, which I'm just speechless. Lava, Earthquake, Arrows, Miner, and even Guards. Guards, way better against Hawk Rider because it's just cheaper cycle. If you play against Barbarians, you can just bait out the Barbarians, an example. And just going for another Hawk Rider, Fire Quickly Barbarians. But Guards are just getting insane amount of value defensive against Hawk Rider because you still need to defend them. Especially kind of going for Skeletons top of your Miner to protect it. So we will see how Mugi is going to win this, because we know Tesla, EQ, Firecracker, Arrows. There's not really a way to defend this, so he always needs to go in. He always needs to keep up the pressure, and he needs to win the game like that. So, he's just going for an Ice Boot in the back. He's just going to cycle Log. Okay. Opponent is going for a Lava Hound in the back. He's just going for a Valkyrie here. Okay. I think he's just gonna go for Firecracker now. Or is he gonna Firecracker that? Let's see. Might Firecracker in the middle, kinda. Just to get a pushback onto the left side and also defense the minions. So, he's just gonna Hawkwire the same, like, second. He's just gonna go for an Ice Brute here and also Skeleton. So, this was just an awesome defense. I think he might lock on the right side. I don't really think so. I think, yeah, he's just gonna lock, because if your opponent decides to go in for Arrows, he has another Firecracker and Psyche, which is smart. But as you guys see, 1000 damage just with Lavons, because the tower needs 3 shots. So he defended perfect, but still the tower's almost down. Not even with a Lava, not even a Balloon. I mean, just a Lava, not even a Balloon or Miner. So, trying to keep up the pressure here. Just going for an Ice Bird. Ice Bird was kind of glitching there, but actually the opponent messed up the King Guild duration, so this is huge for Mugi. He's just going to go Hawk right opposite lane. Defensive Miner needs to come down. And he's just going to do it. So he's going to get like 3 Hawk Rider shots, which I think is a really solid position. But he knows already. He's always splitting his damage. He's always splitting his damage in this matchup because he knows this will be, if it's going to be a win for him, which is looking like not good. And right now, I apologize, guys. It needs to be a 2-1 win, right? Because he will lose his tower 1%. How is he supposed to defend Lava? EQ. So, great lock here. I think he's just going to go for Hawk Rider, and now he's going to for an Inferno Drain. He's just going to go for an Ice Boon. This will be tower down 1%. So he's just going for an EQ here. Most likely on his Tesla, I guess. And Mugi's like, what? What are you playing here? So it actually, the Firecracker gets a ton of value. He's just going for this. He's just most likely going to Miner this maybe. Okay, no, he's not. He's just going to lock it. Just try to cycle 2 locks because he doesn't really need it. So I think he's just going to go Firecracker plus he's just going to go Hawk. Okay, now he's just going to Valkyrie the bridge to support the Hawk Rider. Yes. Okay, great guards, honestly. Smart play by the opponent. So he's just going to go for an Ice Bird here. Try to freeze the Inferno Dragon. This is why he prefers Ice Bird over there, because the freeze effect is like, just longer. And now he's just going to go for another Lava Hound here. And for another Hawk Rider, just going to EQ that. And Mugi actually wins this game.
Who are you?
If you guys don't want to miss any of this new video on the channel, don't forget to subscribe. I'm just speechless how good Mugi is. Let me know in the comment section who is the best player in the world for you guys right now. I'm just like, if I see this gameplay, it's just absolutely insane. I'm so excited for the World Finals. Make sure to subscribe to Mugi's channel because he's just goated and he deserves that. And I would say I'm out. Thanks for watching. And thank you so much for everybody who's using credit card in the shop. Goodbye, guys.